Hi, my name is Destiny Givens, and I'm one of your prom queen candidates for this year's court. Throughout my time at Maryville, I have been involved in numerous activities. I am currently president of FCCLA, our Yes Interact and Yes Interact Club, and I'm also the president of Jack and Jill of America. I also serve in National Honor Society as a freshman mentor in Quill and Scroll. I have been a member of our PNN and newspaper, probably bringing you some of your favorite stories. And I also have served as editor for our newspaper, and I'm also an active member in Quill and Scroll.
Hi, my name is Kaden Morgan. I am a 2023 prom queen candidate. Some of the activities I'm involved in at school, I am a varsity gymnast, a varsity tennis player. I am a freshman mentor. I was just inducted into the National Honor Society this year. I'm also a part of the band. I do concert band, marching band, and pep band at basketball games. So yeah.
Hi, I'm Anna Williams, and I'm one of your 2023 prom queen candidates. During high school, I've been a part of many activities. My freshman year, I was a part of the varsity girls track team. I'm now a member of the varsity girls soccer team. I'm a member of National Honor Society, freshman mentors, Academic Super Bowl, Quiz Bowl. I was previously a member of Business Professionals of America, and on my free time, I volunteer for the homeless with mental health issues.
So my reaction to finding out that I was on the court, I was honestly honored to know kind of teachers recognize my impact in and out of the classroom among students. I really felt happy and excited to be able to experience such this great thing after not having prom for some years since COVID. I feel like it's like the bringing it back after last year. So I'm really excited to see what prom can hold.
All right, so when I found out that I was nominated, I was surprised because there was only one teacher who asked me if I wanted to be nominated. I'm like, sure, why not? But I was actually surprised that it was multiple teachers who like noticed my effort in school. And yeah, so I was just shocked. And I'm just honored that people recognize me as a hard worker and a well-behaved student.
When I first found out that I was going to be a part of this year's 2023 prom court, I was very honored and appreciative that my academic and behavioral achievements were recognized through various teachers. I'm very excited to continue to be a role model for Maryville High School.
My friends would honestly describe me as very outgoing. I'm adventurous, and I would also say determined. I love to kind of do fun things and just be out and have fun. I also just love to work hard with whatever I'm working on and just altogether just try my best in whatever I do.
If my friends were to describe me as a person, they would probably describe me as loud, maybe funny, genuine, honest, hardworking, and caring.
If my friends were to describe me, they would say I'm very articulate, funny, outgoing, determined, and supportive.
During prom weekend, I'm most looking forward to prom itself, seeing everyone dress up, have fun with their friends, and all to kind of have a sense of community. The actual weekend itself after Friday is actually my installation to be installed for President of Jack and Jill of America. So I also have a very busy weekend with that. So kind of also have a mix of having fun but also being serious on prom weekend.
What I'm looking forward to most for prom weekend is first getting dressed up because I don't get dressed up often. So that's always exciting. And I'm just looking forward to, first of all, like the two other girls that are on the court with me, Autumn and Destiny. I'm happy that I'm doing this with them because I like them, like they're good people. So if I'm going through it with anybody, I'd like that it's them. And I'm just also looking forward to just prom in general because it just seems fun, I guess.
What I'm most looking forward to for prom weekend is the process of preparation leading up to prom and enjoying and having a good time with my friends and my prom date.
Again, my name is Destiny Givens, and I would really appreciate all of you guys to vote for me.
Again, I'm Kaden Morgan, and I would really appreciate your vote for prom queen this year. Thank you.
Again, I'm Autumn Williams, and I would be honored to receive your vote for prom queen.
Hi, I'm Carlton Clay, and I'm a prom 2023 king candidate. I've been involved in the advanced string orchestra, the varsity mock child scheme, the superintendent student adversary council, thespian troop, the National Honor Society, as well as being the math team captain for the academic Super Bowl.
Hi, my name is Noah Melinda, and I'm one of your 2023 Prom King candidates. At Maryville High School, I play varsity tennis, and I'm also a captain of the boys' varsity volleyball team. I'm a member of National Honor Society, as well as the Thespian Troop, and I do yearbook and the school newspaper as well.
Hi, my name is Mario Mukes. I am a 2023 Prom King candidate, and I am very excited for this year's nominations. I have been, throughout my high school career, I have been in tennis, volleyball, and I was just inducted in the National Honor Society.
When I found out that I got nominated, I was really surprised. Like, I didn't know, like, how exactly, you know, like, the prom king worked. I didn't even know that juniors could get voted, so, like, if that tells you, like, how oblivious I was. But, like, when I found out, my teacher was like, yeah, I nominated you for prom king. I was like, oh, thank you. And then, like, one day, like, 2 weeks ago, I think, I got, like, the little slip, and I got the big paper, and I was like, oh my gosh, this is such a big deal. But, yeah, I was just super excited to run, and finding out that my friends were also candidates, it was like really cool, really cool. I hate to geek out.
When I found out, I was definitely like a little surprised. I wasn't sure if I was going to prom yet or not, but this sort of influenced my decision. And I was also kind of proud that my teachers chose to nominate me based off like the work I do in class and managing my work in school and all my sports as well. So it was just kind of encouraging.
When I found out I was nominated, I was really surprised because I didn't think my teachers like knew that much about me or would be even considering like nominating me. But like after I found out, I was like really excited for what was to come and what experiences I would have because I wasn't considering going to prom before, but getting nominated made me want to participate in a prom.
Well, if my friends were to describe me, and I've heard it all from menace to society to an amazing person, I think overall they would probably say altruistic. Altruistic really just means like a genuine person, honest, true. And I think a lot of people recognize that within me. And I try to, you know, perceive myself as that in every opportunity that I get. And I really think that they would be able to say that about me, I hope.
I think my friends would describe me as a hard worker, and I'm also like intertwined with like a lot of different friend groups at the school, so I think I'm able to like mesh with people well. So I think I'm just like able to be comfortable around other people and make them comfortable as well, like no matter the circumstances.
My friends would probably describe me as brave, caring, and energetic. I really like to have fun, and I like to do new things a lot. So I don't like to try old things too many times, but I really like having fun and seeing new experiences out of those things.
What I'm looking forward to most for prom weekend would probably be, well, definitely, it would be hanging out with my friends. Like, spending time with them is something that we don't really get to do in high school because we're so busy. But we just have so much planned. We're thinking about going to Chicago or Schaumburg or, you know, just really having a good time. And I'm really excited for that because I love them so bad. Don't tell them that, though.
I'm most excited about hanging out with my friends and just making memories throughout the weekend. I know prom will be fun, just being around all the people that I hang out with on a daily basis. And then probably going out to eat after, too.
The most I'm looking forward to for prom weekend is probably like the big party, like all the music and all of the dancing. I'm really excited for that because homecoming was a lot of fun for me. So I'm very excited for experiencing that. I'm also excited for going out with my friends after. I think we're gonna have a really good time. And if we decide to do any fun things after that, that would be awesome. But getting ready for prom will be really fun, and arriving and seeing everybody's outfits is gonna be a really fun time.
And again, this is Carlton Clay, your 2023 Prom King candidate. And remember that if you wanna slay, vote for Clay.
Once again, I'm Noah Melinda, and I would greatly appreciate your vote for Prom King.
And to end this off, my name is Mario Mukes, and I'm going to be your 2023 Prom King candidate. And it would really be awesome if you guys were to vote for me for Prom King.
Walking through the halls of MHS, many students may not be aware of the hidden talents within their fellow students. The annual MHS Talent Review is an exciting opportunity for Maryville High School students to expose their talents. From auditions to show day, it has been an exciting process for all participating in the Talent Review.
The review dates back to at least the 1970s here at Maryville High School, a long-standing tradition. Originally, it was called the Off-Broadway Review, and it featured groups from the music programs, band and choir. There was no orchestra back then, and you had to be a member of band, choir, or the forensic clubs, the speech and debate, to be able to be a participant in the Off-Broadway Review. Now we have all of the performing arts students are available to be in the show, and basically the show has morphed into an all-school talent show. So we have folks that are not necessarily members of band, choir, orchestra, and those that are not necessarily just showing off the talents that they normally perform for their concerts, but an opportunity to perform different types of repertoire or do different kinds of performances to showcase their talents in a production that's put on every spring. It's kind of a best kept secret of late. The year that we were quarantined for COVID in 2020, that obviously there was no review that year because everything was on pause. And when we came back from that, there was almost half the school population that didn't even know what the review was. So it's taking us a little bit of time to rebuild and to bring back this long-standing tradition. It usually takes place in the spring months, and hopefully you'll get a chance to come out and see the show, and definitely plan to perform with us next year for Revue 2024.
I auditioned to promote theater because I'm in the thespian troupe, and I think it's really fun, and everyone should like have a chance to be able to experience this. I think my audition went pretty well. Miss Reinhardt was really nice, and it's just because I was in a group, so it's even more fun and just have laughs and just enjoy the work of theater.
My audition went pretty well. I actually really enjoyed it. I went to audition because I was at state, and I wanted everyone in the audience who was going to be at the talent show to see what we had put on for state, and that's the reason why I auditioned.
I chose to audition because I want to normalize singing in front of groups of people and crowds, so in the future I'll be good at it.
Hi, I'm Kristen. I am doing my monologue one of which that I did at my Indiana State competition, not mine, but I'm basically going into the review to show people, get them with the idea of what theater is, and it's okay to dip your toes in the water and get a feel of it and just put yourself out there, you know. So, yeah.
All right, so my act is singing. I was to audition this year because last year was a really hard year for me. I was very shy, very in my shell, and this year I've been blooming and blossoming. So I want to step out and get out of my comfort zone and try something different.
All MH students participating in the annual talent review have been so excited for opening night to arrive. They are excited to show the crowd their amazing talents.
I think that our group did really well. I was not expecting to do that well, and I actually thought it turned out really well.
Hi, so this is me after the talent review. I think we did pretty well. I was really nervous. A lot of my whole group was really nervous, but overall it was fun, and I think we did great.
I think I did great. I had a loud crowd, and I felt very confident, so it was fun.
I think I did okay. I got a few comments back saying that I wasn't loud enough backstage. They couldn't hear me, but I feel like overall I did good. Super proud of myself.
Hi, I'm back. I think I'm gonna say I did pretty good. Of course, there could have been improvements in places. I'm not gonna say that I messed up, and if I did mess up, but I really enjoyed myself, and I am very happy to be a part of this again. Thank you.
It is safe to say that the talent show was a success for all students involved. Everyone worked hard, and it paid off in the end. It takes great courage to go on stage and perform for an audience, so huge applause to all involved.
PNN reporter Omarion Thomas has brought many of our favorite sports stories to the PNN Friday shows, from the playoffs to highlighting championship games. Mr. Harvath, one of the PNN teachers, sent some of Omarion's segments to one of his favorite teams, the Chicago Bulls. The Bulls organization loved the segments and sent Omarion a personal invite to one of their final games.
What made me want to send Omarion's segments into the Chicago Bulls is because I've been working with Omarion for about 2 years now. Omarion is a huge, lifelong Chicago Bulls fan, and I just thought this would be an incredible opportunity for him to learn from some professional broadcasters and also get a really cool experience at a Bulls game. I didn't think anything would come of it because a lot of the times when you send stuff to PR departments, you don't really hear anything back other than thank you for your request. However, the Bulls were very generous in accommodating us, and it made for an amazing experience for Omarion.
Of course, with Omarion learning that his segments got sent into the Bulls, there were many feelings that came along with that.
I felt very honored and I was very excited to know that they invited me to be to have the experience.
The excitement from Omarion was unreal, having been able to experience behind the scenes with Chuck Swirsky and Adam Amin.
When we went there, the Bulls organization went above and beyond. We met one of the interns there. They brought us down to the floor. Omarion then got to speak with two of their radio announcers who spent a good 25, 30 minutes with Omarion talking about his ambitions, what he'd like to do with a career in broadcasting. They also showed them their notes as far as what they have to do to prepare for a game with stats and stories about the players and really kind of hit home to Omarion. You know, it's not just showing up and doing some announcing that you're like any career, you have to put some work into it. You have to really know what you're talking about. Both of these announcers made a fantastic impression on Omarion the whole time. He was smiling and laughing, and I think it was just kind of one of those one-of-a-kind experiences for him.
My favorite experience was when I got to meet some of the players and actually see them on the court. And another part of my experience was when I got to meet some of the broadcasters. I felt that was a pretty cool experience because it really taught me a lot more than I thought I knew already.
Of course, with great experiences, there are also great memories, and definitely ones that will be impactful as Omarion continues.
It impacted me because I got to see like what really goes on and how much work actually goes into what they do as sports broadcasters.
PNN would like to extend a huge thank you to the Chicago Bulls and the announcers that made this experience so special for Omarion. We wish him the best of luck as he continues on his journey in broadcasting. Signing off of PNN, I'm Destiny Givens.
As we get closer to summer break, there are a lot of events happening for the senior class. One day that many people might not know of is Decision Day. May 1st is the day that seniors announce what college they are going to. It can be an exciting event as it is a big part of a senior's life.
I chose Northern Illinois University because they like the only place that did accept me, and I want to stay close to home. Family is most important to me and everything.
I'm going to Purdue University Northwest in Hammond, and I'm going there because, you know, it's close to home, it's local. I get to stay with family still, look over some family members still, and I still get a good education, you know, there, and they offer the major I want to major in.
I'm going to be attending Ball State University, and I'm majoring in musical theater, and I was interested because my cousin is an alumni there. One of my coaches is also an alumni there, and they have a really good musical theater program, and yeah.
Graduating high school is a big task, and some seniors can't help but wonder if they're ready for the next step.
Honestly, me personally, I don't think I'm ready for college. I don't think I'm ready. I'm barely passing high school right now, so I don't believe I'm ready for college. I don't want to be on my own. I don't want to cook for myself. I don't want to clean for myself. So, I mean, like, I'm not ready for this adulthood, but I mean, like, I'm going to get ready eventually.
I think, you know, throughout these past 4 years and really even beyond, I've been taught a lot of things, you know, to do when I become more independent, to really make me, like, try to make me a good adult as possible. My parents taught me well, good morals and everything. No, I know how to cook. I know how to, like, you know, do dishes, do laundry, and every, like, throw out the trash. There's typical things adults usually do by themselves when they live by themselves to be very independent of themselves.
Yes, I think I'm ready for college. I'm, like, semi-ready. I'm, like, halfway there, halfway not there. I say I'm there because the work ethic, that's what I'm ready to put in. Because people talk about some, oh, yeah, college is going to be da-da-da-da-da. I'm like, okay, I hear you. I hear you. I hear exactly what y'all saying. But what I think I'm not ready is the procrastination and the waking up on time. That's the hard part right there. That's the hard part.
Decision day is coming up, so seniors, get ready to announce your schools. Signing off from PNN, I'm Jenny Pleasant.
Tonight, you need to celebrate today because it is a great milestone. But as Miss Escobedo said, it's just the beginning of a journey. Never rest on your accomplishments and continue to be determined as new obstacles will come your way. And I promise you they will. But over these past 4 years, you have learned how to get through adversity, make good choices, be on time. And like Ms. Escobedo said, be where you're supposed to be, take an active role in that process, and good things will always happen to you.
You can fight endlessly on the supposition that there are good guys and bad guys. And when we fight on that supposition, there is no possibility of compromise or of gentleman's agreement. As there is honor among thieves. We're all thieves. Let's face it, 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 face it.
Time is slowly fading for seniors at MHS while our youth is now turning to maturity. The older we grow, the more we appreciate the memories that were created. Seniors express their emotions in their last lap of high school.
Hi, my name is Taylor Washington. I'm a senior and I want to be a conservative journalist. So I have a lot to tell younger Taylor. Taylor was going through a lot. She was very insecure. She felt like she wasn't good enough. She compared herself a lot to people. So I would just say, like, don't compare yourself to where you are now compared to someone else, because they could be a lot farther down in their journey and you're just now beginning. And that's something I used to do a lot, and I don't do it as much anymore, but don't compare yourself. Yeah, you might not feel good enough, but you can learn and you can grow. I would also tell myself not to give up my beliefs for someone or try to negotiate what I believe in or compromise my beliefs, because I think a belief system is very important for how you interact with people, like your morality and what you believe in. So don't compromise your morals at all, because that's pretty much the foundation of how you live your life. And my last thing would be, like, put yourself in uncomfortable situations. I feel like a lot of times, freshman through junior year, and even now, like, I didn't put myself in places with tension, and I was kind of used to being comfortable. And being comfortable doesn't allow me to grow as a person. And I feel like now I've really learned how to kind of be comfortable with being uncomfortable, because you really learn from situations in doing that. So, yeah. Yeah, I will miss my days in high school, just because ninth grade was really fun. I don't miss sophomore year at all. Junior year was okay. It kind of went by really fast. But yeah, I will say that I'll miss it, because a lot of my friends are here. And I don't know, it's just high school is kind of where I learned how to be myself. I would say my least favorite memory was sophomore year. I think it was my worst memory, or just my worst point in high school, because I didn't try at all. I remember we would call on Zoom, and I would just be goofing off, and I had to suffer for that in junior year. So I definitely should have applied myself more. And I think just COVID and everything kind of knocked me off. Like, I wasn't how I normally was. I wasn't trying as hard. So I think that's why it was my least favorite. I think PNN really got me into journalism, and more so like broadcasting, because, you know, PNN, you can ask people questions and you can state your opinions on different political viewpoints. And I just really like seeing people's point of views and kind of seeing people come to a consensus or like finding common ground. And I noticed a lot in media, there's not really a conservative perspective. Like, media is more so left-leaning or democratic, which there's nothing wrong with that, but I feel like it's fair to have both sides. So I kind of want to bring that perspective that's different from what media normally has. And I feel like as a conservative journalist, I can do that. I like writing about stuff. I like asking people their point of views on things. So I think journalism, or no, PNN really helped me find that. And then you can edit videos and stuff. A lot of people don't like talking about stuff like that, but I feel like if we bring awareness to it, it'll allow people to stop feeling uncomfortable to talk about things. And like, if we make it normalized to say how you feel about things, people won't be canceled for having different opinions. Because I think if we want to talk about inclusion, we should also talk about the inclusion of different opinions, not just like sexuality, whatever, just like the inclusion of what you believe in your opinion. I think that's really important too.
We got 9 minutes, Eli, so take your time. It's gonna be one set, and yeah.
My name is Elijah Ace, and what I want to be after high school is an animator, 2D animator, specifically. We're making memories right now, so of course I'm going to miss those times, and what lessons would I take? All of them. Like, you know, how to talk to people, how to engage, you know, how to just be yourself, all of them. My plan is after high school, I'm going to go to Arizona, right, go to Arizona University. And how is this going to affect my life? I get to go to a new state. I get to travel a little bit more. You know, I have freedom because I won't be under my parents' roof no more. So, you know, and I can finally start doing what I really want to do, like making animations and stuff, because I think I'll still have like free time. So it's going to affect my life positive. And after I move to Arizona, I'm going to be positive. And I most definitely will have roommates. Most definitely have roommates with like two of my best friends.
My name is D'Angelo Mosley, DJ Mosley, and what I want to be when I grow up is a video game designer. I will miss my younger days in high school, but I was out for 2 years because of the COVID outbreak and all that stuff, so I will still miss my old days because it was fun. And all the lessons I've learned many. I'll take most of them because some of them were pretty tedious and that's just stuff I deal with every day, but yeah. My plans after high school is to go to a college. And go to a college around here first to start, graduate within a year, and get my video game designer degree so I can start with my new computer, start creating what I want.
Many could look at these as our own personal last dance, but as for freshmen, seniors offer advice to the kids who have a long road ahead of them.
If you say you want to do something, just do it. The more you say you're going to do it and you just leave it to the side, you're not getting anything done. I pushed for the things I wanted and I got what I wanted because I made a way for it. So don't doubt yourself. If you think you can't do it, try something new. Always make sure that you feel comfortable doing it. Don't have anybody hold you.
And this is optional. You don't got to answer this. Do you have any advice you would give the freshmen?
Okay. So freshmen. You know, I was a freshman once. I would say my advice is focus on school. Like, yeah, you might want to date around, you might want to have fun, which is okay, you can do that. But I think school should be your number one priority because you're setting yourself up for success if you pay attention. If you have a homework assignment and it's due Thursday and you got it Tuesday, start on it early, you know? It might seem nice to put it off and not get it done, but if you start on the work early, like, start thinking for the long-term benefits and not the short term. Because short term, you didn't do your homework, now you're rushing trying to get it done in class, but if you get it done like early, you know, you'll be happy that you did that. So try to be disciplined, try to get your work done on time, don't try to put things off. And I'm still trying to like follow my own advice, so nobody's perfect, obviously, but just try your best and like set goals for yourself, you know? So that's my advice.
Any advice to freshmen? just be yourself. That's all I really have to say. Just be yourself. Like, no matter what, just be yourself. Don't be too, like, serious, because then you're gonna look, what's the word? You're gonna look constricted or stiff. Just be yourself. Like, just be loose. Go with your flow.
Seniors will miss their high school career, but will never forget the laughs, smiles, and excitement that was shared. Our time will never be forgotten and remembered as a wild journey. Signing off for PNN, I'm Michael LeGrand. We'll see you next time on the Return to Kickoff.